Hi everyone, I'm Linda Peterson. Thanks for joining me today on this episode of Friendly Plastic TV. I'm excited to bring this episode to you because I'm going to show you a technique using alcohol inks and altering the color of your friendly plastic. We're going to be creating a beautiful springtime floral pendant. I'm going to show you how to color strips of friendly plastic using the alcohol ink and markers. As you can see up here in this corner here, I have some puddles of alcohol ink that have dried out. And the reason that I let them dry is because that intensifies their pigment. In this little bottle cap here, I have a little bit of just regular rubbing alcohol, and I have a paintbrush. So to reconstitute the alcohol ink that is already dried, you're just going to dip your brush into the rubbing alcohol and pretty randomly daub it on, just like that. Anytime you want to change colors, just rinse that out a little bit, change colors. I'm working with a palette of kind of corally colors. It's a magenta, an orange, and a purple, and when these blend together, then they make additional colors, which really adds to the effect. And you can see that I've already started it over here. Let me add a little bit more purple there. And of course, you'll want to continue until your entire strip has been colored with the inks. I love this because it just adds so much versatility to your friendly plastic. As you can see, now I have my entire strip of pearl friendly plastic covered with ink. And I've missed a few bits and pieces here and there. It doesn't really matter. You don't have to be perfect. Now what I'm going to come in and do is add some extra effects with my plain rubbing alcohol. So if you'll dip your brush into the alcohol and then you'll add little droplets, you can create some real nice little watermark effects. Next, we're going to shape the petals. I've already started three petal shapes, and all you do with that is you're going to use your scissors, cut off a section that is about a half an inch wide, and then cut this into a petal shape. If you happen to have a petal cutter, like a cookie cutter that's shaped into a teardrop or a petal, that would work well. You would just have to heat your plastic first, and then you can cut your petal shapes out that way and let them cool. So you'll need a total of 5 petals. You'll want to finish the edges of your petals so that they're nice and neat. And to do that, what I've done is I've applied a little bit of Rub and Buff to my fingertip here, as you can see, and I've just outgone along the sides of all my petals and given them a little, oops, I missed one, little metallic finish. You can also rub this on the back of your petals to finish the backs off, or you can paint them. Sometimes I just paint them black. So you'll finish all of your petals with the Rub and Buff. I'm using antique gold. Next, to kind of add a little bit of sparkle and flair, I have gone in with a toothpick here. I have a little cap full of just regular white acrylic paint and a toothpick. And these little circles here, these little watermarks that have been left by the little droplets of the alcohol ink, I'm going to highlight those. So I'm just going to add little dots all the way around. Gives it just a little extra pattern, a little extra texture, and it makes them show up a little more. So once all of your petals have dried, all the paint and all your extra embellishment is dried, it's time to assemble the flower. So what I've done is I've heated a scrap of plastic, just this plastic right here in the center, and I have arranged all my petals all the way around. I have not heated these petals, just the centerpiece of plastic. And I've bent each of my petals to kind of give them a little bit of a curve. I have not heated these petals. This is just the raw plastic that I'm giving a little bit of a curve to. Hold it for a second or two, and then just add it there to the plastic. Let your center cool, and then all of these will be attached. Once it's cool, then you can apply any rhinestones or any kind of center embellishment that you want. And if you want an idea, take a look at my finished project. I love mixing alcohol inks with my friendly plastic because it just expands the possibilities. This technique is great with fracture and fusion, or maybe you just have a special little cutter that you want to cut out of shape, stick it on a pendant, and you have a piece of wear and go jewelry. Wonderful. If you need more project ideas, be sure to check us out on our blog at friendlyplastic.blogspot.com. I would love to have you join us there. Love to hear your comments, even send me a picture, and I'll highlight you on the blog. You can also connect with us on Facebook, and we have loads more of YouTube videos on our YouTube channel at Friendly Plastic TV. Well, that's going to do it for this episode. Thanks for joining me. I'll see you again real soon.